Hey there, YouTube. I'm Yukitsu. This is Yukitsu Times. Welcome to my channel. Welcome back to Total War Attila, our legendary playthrough. So, we're not making much money is sort of my observation that I've kind of come to the conclusion of here. We should actually probably clear these rebels out. I believe that rebels automatically default to raiding stance, so I think that's part of what's hurting our economy, but, like, there's a lot of things that are hurting our economy, let's be frank here. Let's go ahead and check here. Okay, so that's not where we check that, Corruption, huh, okay, well, that's interesting. So let's try and, actually, I might have to check another thing instead here. How's Tomosuke going to be doing here? Okay, I don't actually think I could beat that there, so we'll have to recruit an admiral. We get paid a lot by hunting those guys down anyway. I would just like to be able to hunt them down with this army, that would be fantastic, but I don't think that's really in the cards for us right now. Yeah, so we're just going to have to hang on by the skin of our teeth until we can get hereditary service done. As you can see, we've got to 155% research rate now on this stuff. So we can actually get hereditary service in 2 turns now. So we're going to go ahead and get regional traditions first, and then we'll go ahead and get that. So it should be good. Man, we have got so many little fires to put out here. And that's sort of... that's sort of what Western Rome is in this game. It's crisis management. It's sort of trying to find out how to prioritize everything so that you can get as much as possible done. And for some people, that means abandoning things that they don't think are priority. For me, it's trying to maximize my positioning to figure out how to resolve every single crisis that happens. Okay, that's just my playstyle. And I think it pays off. I mean, you can see that we've got pretty much all of Britain here locked down, because the only people left are the people from Eberacum, or Eblana, rather, and they're peaceful with me. So we've got that going for us. So, alright, which of these fights do we want to do first? Let's go ahead and do this one, I think. This one's going to be the rougher one. We'll start with this harder one first this time. Well, this isn't going to be too bad. Fundatores... pretty dangerous. Their cavalry is extremely dangerous, but they've only got 3 infantry. They've got their catapult there. And we'll have our Sagittarii, our Scout Equites, and our cohorts coming in as aid. So, again, we're just going to let the auger run itself out. Alright, so here we are on the battlefield, and we've got fog. Okay, I'm going to take this. Foggy old Britain. So anyway, we're going to go ahead and move ourselves back just a little bit. This is going to actually be tricky in some ways because our axes will get absolutely annihilated by any sort of cavalry that gets near them. So we have to be very, very mindful of that and very, very careful about that. Now, if I can snipe out some of them with these very light skirmishers here, we are going to have a chance, but we have to do that very, very successfully. Not the easiest thing. Neither of our cavalry units can beat their cavalry in a fight, and none of our infantry, other than the Comitatensis, can do anything to hold on against them front on. So it's that sort of paradox that we get into here, where we can't use anything to stop them, but once we do, any of these units, once those cavalry are stopped, no longer in a charge bonus motion, will be able to defeat them, except for the Scout Equites, really. They can't do jack diddly, but... Like, the problem with these guys, very, very low health, very low armor, and they've got fairly low, actually, this one's got medium unit mass, it's not terrible, but what you want typically is something like heavy spear infantry, or very heavy spear infantry. They've got, there's a stat called unit mass, essentially, in this game, which tells you how likely your something's going to get bowled over, or bowl an enemy over, so very heavy cavalry is more likely to bowl a unit over than my Scout Equites here, which are very light. Now, light cavalry does actually make up for this a little bit because they've got much, much faster movement speed. And that movement speed also has a part of the calculation, but ultimately what you're looking for is units that have that high mass. Those cataphracts, very heavy cataphract units, have the most devastating charges in the game because they're very heavy, not just because their charge bonus is higher. In fact, you'll often find charge cavalry, like lancers like this, with higher charge values when they're lighter, and that's just to make up for the fact that they won't bowl as many units over on the charge, so it makes a huge difference. And there's also more sticking with light units, I found. The heavier units are able to push their way out of conflicts a little bit better. Alright, let's go ahead and get you guys all grouped up here. Double time. Order. right. You guys are in locked formation, right? Yeah, and you've got a properly locked formation. Good. Now, I'm taking my brigands off of fire at will, because I do need to either assassinate their general with them, or I need to take out their cavalry. There's no real other use for them here. Oh, this is really shit. Okay, there we go. One of the things I've noticed about this game, like, my computer doesn't run well at the best of times, but when you're trying to do battles in this that are extremely large, or have the particle effects, the game really goes to pot. It's kind of tragic, but that's sort of the way it's always been. Rain is actually by far the worst, though, so I'm thankful we don't have that today. Although, you know, rain battles are advantageous in plenty of situations, so... Alright, cavalry, do I want to put them in group 2? Probably not, really. You can also see the behavior for different things, like, we've got these very light cavalry and these light cavalry. You can see how much more spaced these light skirmisher cavalry are compared to the light cavalry. And as you get into the heavy, super heavy charge cavalry, their formation tightens up even more. Similar to how these cohorts over here have a more spaced out formation than the spear unit equivalent, and these axe units have a more spaced out formation than those guys. So different unit types, different densities, and also how heavy they are changes the density. That unit density also changes how they interact against cavalry charges. It's kind of interesting how many different little things go into that, I think. Alright, so there's no way in hell that I really want to get into a prolonged skirmishing match against these guys, so there's going to come a point where I'm going to have to just rush forward with all of my guys if they start moving up. And it does look like they are just moving up, so they might actually be moving up their entire army, including their catapults. They're just readjusting there, yeah. So let's not worry about that too much. Let's just move up into range of that catapult. Alright, their Contarii are on this side, so I'm going to send these guys over here. It's kind of nice that their spears are over on this side as well, so that works out pretty well for me. Alright, so these guys are going to get plastered by rocks a little bit, that's fine. I'm going to switch these to fire, since we were going to go after these guys. It's nice to fight in the fog, because they've got these two units of Fundatores. It's going to really limit the amount of damage that I can take from those guys before I close into melee. So that's ideally why I want to do it. It also seems to be reducing the accuracy of their catapults a little bit. It's all range units have worse accuracy in this sort of weather, so it's working out pretty well for me so far. Boom. Only killed one guy. This is compared to last time where every... Oh, well, actually, there come the casualties. It's compared to, like, last time where I had lost, what, 40 men off of the rocks, though? So even here, this is going pretty well. I think it's because they stand in, like, these neat little rows where they're pretty easily wiped out by artillery. Although that didn't look too effective. Yeah, only 4 kills. Is that the best you got? Alright. So we're going to go ahead and hit fast forward, let those things run their ammunition dry really quickly there. Well, they might actually kill about as many, or even more, actually. That's kind of upsetting, honestly, because they're not supposed to be able to hit quite as effectively in this kind of weather, but... You know what? I might have moved closer than I needed to, or something like that. I don't know. Alright, we're down to... not that many archers, but you know what? That's fine. The only problem that I'm going to have here is dealing with their cavalry. I'm not too worried about their infantry right now, so... Let's go ahead and grab up our brick of infantry here. Let's turn them into a different group. I think I don't really care too much what our archers are doing. Let's go ahead, put them back into this tight formation. We'll ungroup them because I don't really need them grouped. But what we're going to do is have them sort of back here. We're going to have them become our sort of cavalry hunters along with a lot of other things. I just need to kill this Contarii, same as last time. Alright, you guys. Our right flank is going to be dicey just because the enemy is going to be able to get around and do some pretty nasty stuff to us. I might be able to do a lure with the... I'm going to try doing a lure with my skirmisher cavalry here. Man, my throat is just terrible today. Alright, so we're going to try and get a lure onto these Contarii, come around their flanks, and try and wipe out some of those guys, because if we can do that, we're going to be in a good position. Shifting their lines now to deal with that. Looks like they don't want me going after their Contarii with those cavalry, but... I don't know, maybe I can lure them close to my lines with this. Yeah, they want me to waste my ammunition on their catapult crew, just sort of like how I do it, but the AI definitely is smart enough to cover their assets here. Alright, I think we're just going to have to go in, and then we'll start hunting them down once we're sort of seeing them try to engage. We'll have you guys aimed specifically at them, though. Alright. Friend of mine talking about achievements in Electronic Superjoy. Good for him, I guess. Or not, I don't really know. You guys are in skirmishing behavior, right? Okay, we just need to charge there. It's gonna go poorly for us, but whatever. Okay, so our cavalry over here is going to get chased off here. And we're gonna turn them back onto fire at will. And they're going to be able to kill a whole boatload of their units that way. Alright. Let's get around there. Let's get you guys into those fundatories. Oh shit. Okay, well we got caught up too. We're gonna lose all of these raiders here. I'm surprised. I thought that my guys were faster than the Kantari-E, but the Kantari-E must have enough movement speed to be equal.
The men are broken and running for their lives.
Alright, so it doesn't really matter in the grand scheme of things, probably, because we're crushing them everywhere else. Let's get these guys out of this fight and let's get them over there. Alright, you guys get in there, get these guys back behind these spears a little bit, that would be fantastic. Look at the devastating effect that those charges have.
Enemy units have been rallied.
Alright, so those axe units that got hit there are gonna take a big pounding. Fundatories, they're shattered. So this isn't going that smoothly, but you know what, I think we're gonna win here. Yeah, we lost that axe unit. Not that surprised. But at the same time, I'm not really that concerned, because we are going to be losing this army at the end of this whole debacle, essentially. We're going to go ahead and get rid of the army. We don't need it, so let's use this. It's not going to help any, but... Alright, so when these guys don't get their charge bonus, we really don't have to worry about them at all. Alright, axe unit has recovered. Gonna bring them back around to the fight. Try and get into these guys. Alright, so these guys have rallied. Let's go ahead and get them towards those guys. Those... Yeah, like, when these Kantari don't get that charge, that's the difference. Like, it makes a huge difference. I'm willing to chase if they can't get that. But otherwise, it's just not worth it. Alright, you guys... Gonna bring one of our units of Axemen back to this fight. Get our general around into this fight, too. I don't really care if he gets into it a little bit. Alright. So this is pretty bloody and kind of awful, but you know what? That's fine. I think we're doing okay, guys. Yeah, those Equites Dalmate do outclass my Scout Equites quite a bit, but if they've taken a bit of damage in a melee, then that really does sort of knock the wind out of them pretty quickly. Oh yeah, that general's completely gone. We'll make sure we kill him, though. Otherwise, we might have to fight another battle against these guys. Cohort's over here, getting smashed by the cavalry around back there, in addition to those axes that already outclass them. Like, axes are pretty bad in this game, but they outclass cohorts in a straight punch-up fight. The only reason that the cohorts are kind of better is that they can brace against cavalry and survive those sort of fights, even if they're not great against them. And of course, they're also much, much more durable against missiles and stuff like that. Alright, so we don't know for sure that we killed this general, so we're gonna go ahead and just really grind it out down to nothing. We don't care too much about those cohorts, especially because there's only one of them left. Those guys over there, there's two fundatories. Like, we basically crushed this army. I don't think there's really going to be anyone left of it. Yeah, they're down to, like, 5-4. I have seen the general be the last member of a unit surviving, so we can't be too complacent about that. So we're going to go ahead and make sure we completely kill every single person in this unit. It's probably stuck in a kill animation loop, getting, like, bumped out of it or something. Alright, there we go. Now, it looks like I took a lot of losses, and I kind of did, but a lot of our units are still pretty healthy at the end, so... Look at those Kantari, like, they're so brutal. So brutal. But we can continue marching onward with this army
to try
and deal with some problems that might have arisen in Lund... further north, I guess. I don't really remember. Anyway, I will see you on the campaign map. Okay, and here we are. As you can see, we've completely wiped out that force there. We could get a little bit of money, or we could get a little bit of unit replenishment. I'm kind of leaning towards unit replenishment just because of how badly battered my units got in that process, so we'll go ahead and take on warriors. Why not? We'll check what our happiness situation is down here. It shouldn't be that bad. We're at minus 60 and we're taking minus 6 turns. That's not bad. That means it'll take a little while before that actually kicks in. Now, it does ramp up over time, so we do have to be a little bit careful about that. Do we get anything new here? Public order 5 from local province. Is that a new one? I think that might be a new one. Let's check out something real quick here. Provinces. Ones with governors. Baetica has one. They're going up in happiness per turn. Let's just double check. Yeah, sometimes it's due to rebels, so you have to be careful about that. Britannia inferior or superior. Oh, that's because of rebels. Okay, Carthage is going up, not because of rebels. You can tell it's because of rebels because it will always be plus 20 per turn. Okay, so they don't need one. Galicia, okay, the Galician governor needs one because they're at minus 1 per turn. So let's go ahead and add that to your retinue here. Public order plus 5. And that will be fantastic. Like, that will really help us out. Looks like he might have leveled, but... oh no, I must have already done that. Okay. Alright. Kind of wondering, actually. Do we have enough for anything here? I don't think so. We're getting kind of more, though, so that's good. So this should drop to a plus 4 per turn, or go up to, or however you want to look at it. So that should be fun. Okay, we're just gonna... Yeah, enemy killed in battle. Okay, this was over here, was it? Yeah, it was you. We don't need extra zeal all that much here. Yeah, so just sort of the normal stuff going along there would be fine. Can I get up to Saguntium? I don't actually have to get up to Saguntium next turn. The thing is, I can get to Lindum and then attack them from there, but... It's a little bit problematic in a certain sense, so I might be smarter to go all the way up to here. We should also check what we've got available for mercenaries that we could recruit. Okay. So, yeah, I feel like we are going to have to go here because often these guys will retreat. And when I have to run him down, it's not going to be that kind to me, really. Alright, so we've got plus 4 over here. One thing that I could do that's quite interesting, I could really buff up this army quite a bit, spend the rest of my money on buffing up this army, and then we could use a double team attack against Ablana there. That would be potentially quite good. I could also try stationing this navy here for now, because like the Jutes are still quite a far ways away, it looks like. I'm not even sure if they're moving to attack me here. So that changes that to a minus 2. Colony Agrippina is going to revolt, or this region, I guess, is going to revolt. Let's go ahead and get a capital built there. It's good that I had that money still saved up there, enough for that at the very least. Argentoratum, how are things going? This is actually in positives right now. How's Ubersus? They're going to be okay for a few more turns.
We hunger for battle.
Yeah, we moved you guys to there deliberately. This is going to be a hard turn, guys. Okay, you guys, we finished our thing there. We're going to have a revolt here next turn regardless, so we can tax province again. Oh yeah, they're already on taxes. Okay, we should actually check to see if there was anywhere else that was being tax-free, just so I could get out of those, but... Okay, looks like there aren't any more places that I can tax again. It will be nice to have this back up, this up though, the governor's house. Hopefully we'll have a rebellion somewhere around, like, Hadramentum or something like that, somewhere close to there, Hadramentum. That would be the ideal sort of situation. I guess we should deal with this rebellion here. This one should be pretty easy because we've got a pretty large army stack there. Alright.
Would that I were as swift as the angels!
And you know, I think we can go ahead and auto-resolve this one. Like, I don't care if I lose another unit of Comitatus Tensus, have to consolidate together, or just outright lose a unit or two. It doesn't really matter tremendously, because we don't need big garrisons down here. Okay, that's done. Yeah, we lost another unit of Comitatus Tensus. You know what? I'm fine with that. Let's go ahead and potentially get the cash here.
At once.
Good, good. So we've got enough to get another building, potentially. Can we make it back to Tomosuga? We definitely cannot. Okay, so let's go ahead and use this normal stance. We'll have to draw up an admiral for the short term, just for a little while here. We should have enough growth that this place gets this population surplus pretty soon, but let's go ahead and get this guy. Who do we want? Let's go with merchants. We don't have enough ability to recruit a political animal into the family, so... Alright. Fleet reporting. Fantastic. How much are we going to have at Tomosuga in the end here? We're going to have a crappy small unit and a crappy small boat, so we might want to get one mercenary ship, or actually we might want to just get like a bunch of mercenary ships to make sure that this guy doesn't buy them, because he might buy them. That is an actual risk that we'd have at our throats. Let's go ahead and get at least that one, and at least that one. If he gets the last ship there, I'm not going to be too worried about it. And this gives us the flexibility of, if he doesn't actually come into port at Tomosuga, we can hunt him down. We could run their fleet down and actually win. Alright, so... Yeah, we can keep our Komodo Tensa set as they are here. It doesn't really need any additions. Alright, our Severia army, did we have... Yeah, let's go ahead and get that. That'll activate next turn. We don't actually gain any bonuses from that just yet, so what we'll want to do is have that kick in before we start recruiting a bunch of units for him. And when we do, that will start them off at a higher level, so that should be good for us. We might have enough for a spy left over. Just barely. Yeah, we've got enough for one. None of these have great abilities, so... let's just go Agents and Regis. Doesn't really matter, but what does matter is that he's level 3. So we can get 2 levels of Investigate Corruption, and unfortunately he doesn't have any real abilities that help tremendously for the local region in a natural sense. So what I can do here is just take Misdirection. So that should be good. Constant local effects, minus 20% chance of being detected, and zeal plus 1. Okay, we'll go ahead and get that as well, so people are less likely to know that he is a thing. Now, Investigate Corruption reduces corruption by 20%, which is huge. Like, Investigate Corruption action at level 2, or 10%? Is it only 10%? I don't actually know what this does when you do it and you don't have... that upgrade, like, well, whatever, it doesn't really matter, but it should be a big boost to our income, regardless, so that should be fine. Alright. We can't, yeah, I don't know what to do here, really, but, yeah, there's a lot of crap going on. Let's check our list here one more time for event messages, figure out where we're going to have new rebellions going on here. Africa. Okay, we knew about that. Belgica. That was over here. Lugdunensis. Yeah, that was going to be over here. Is there anything I can do to stop this one for a turn so that I can make sure that I've got enough generals? Because I don't think I've got... Actually, no, that was an admiral I hired. But I don't know if I've got enough generals in reserve that I can recruit them, regardless of whether or not I've got enough maximum armies. Okay. But I can use the army from here to deal with one of the two. So whichever is closer to these guys can deal with that. So I either have to have him near Belgica or I need him near Lugdunensis. I don't need him near both. Lusitania is down all the way over here. And we'll definitely need to recruit someone for that. And we're actually trying to get our public order in control in this region here, so things are going okay. So that should be everything that we need to think about this turn. Now, next turn is going to be winter. We should be earning a little bit more since I believe the bonus for winter is industrial bonus. We don't have that much industry, but it should be okay. Let's figure out where we want to put that spy. I should have done this earlier before I actually recruited the damn bastard. All right, region wealth. We want it to be for everything because that's what matters here. Okay, so Terrico or... I wish it showed you like the whole province as a whole. Carthage could actually rival Terrico just from Carthage itself, but I think that might be one of our richest regions. Let's go ahead and actually just check through this way. Okay, so Carthage is 1,564 turn in income, which is huge. Italia, 1,203. Magna Graecia, 1,286. We've got Tarco, 1,378. So it looks like Carthage is, in fact, our highest grossing city. So getting him down to there, getting him set up in that stance, is going to increase our income pretty significantly. And they're actually increasing in happiness despite illness. So this will increase over time, even if I don't do anything. So that's pretty good. The one problem I'm looking at is that we don't seem to be getting... It doesn't seem like we're earning any money anywhere, which is a bit problematic. How come this place is so happy? Military presence is worth 16. Oh, holy crap. Okay, well, I guess actually we have got two fairly large armies there. So that'll suppress this region's desire to revolt against me and my August rule a little bit. So, yeah, that should be just about everything that we can manage here. All right, I think we're just going to... I'm going to scan through diplomacy really quickly, just through everything one more time. But that should be our... turn. I'll see you once I've gone through everything and tell you if anything really important crops up. Okay, welcome back. So I've gone over pretty much everything and I can't think of anything I can do to sort of better my situation here. I did sort of move units around just a tiny bit, just to make them a little bit closer. I should have actually run these guys straight this direction anyway, but they were kind of in the wrong spot anyway. They moved up this way to attack that army, so I would have moved south and then across anyway, but it'll take me a couple turns to get to Constantina if that's where the rebellion shows up. If we're at Hadrumentum, it'll be these guys that will get there first, and hopefully they'll be able to squash that pretty quickly. Other than that, things are going as they're going. Now, one of the things I could do, if they do spawn in the good spot there, these guys could actually make it into this region here, probably within two turns. So we could probably deal with a rebellion up here as well, if it's at Emerita Augusta, maybe, something like that, but we'd have to see. It would take them longer before they would assault a walled city like this, so it's possible, but... Regardless, I kind of have to keep the number of generals on circling duty, being hired and fired over and over again, to as much of a minimum as possible, just because otherwise I'll run out of generals eventually. Basically simple as that. I feel like I can get rid of these guys. They're kind of, like, really good, but they're petering off in their utility now just because they're so squishy. So we're going to go ahead and disband this unit. We'll free up a tiny, tiny bit of money. Not much, but a tiny, tiny bit. Anyway, let's go ahead and hit end turn. See how things go. I mean, I don't actually have to kill the Abdanians anytime soon, which is part of the reason why I'm so relaxed about that whole situation with them being there. Ostrogoths have decided to run off and set to raiding stance in the woods. The Visigoths are continuing their rampage through Eastern Roman territory. Alright, so I don't actually know what they were doing there. Like, they kind of did that sort of cups and balls thing where they're sort of moving around, and I don't know if they moved closer to me or away from me the way they moved there. But I get the feeling like I don't have to worry about them just yet. I don't think they moved that much closer. Eastern Romans, what are they doing here? I get the feeling like they just moved that unit that was sort of north of the Visigoths. These guys really need to get their transport ships up near Constantinople. Like, I don't know what they're doing with these ships here, but they definitely shouldn't be lingering around where they are there. Oh, great. These guys have now decided to camp around my stuff. Looks like we've got our rebels in Colonia Agrippina. Yeah, and Olisipo. So we're definitely not getting our... Yeah, we'll chase this guy down with our admiral, why don't we? We can try chasing him down. I think that's possible for us. If he's up to three ships now, we know it's not really worth it. Oh, Judea is a province now. Interesting. I might have missed that earlier. Alright, Magna Graecia is about to get a rebellion, which is fun. But we might be able to disband an army or two here. Office secured. Good. Office secured. Office secured. Ooh, up to minus 10 bonus from presence of dramatic paganism. That's going to be huge. Fantastic. So Uberz is going to have a problem, but that's fine. These guys, office secured. Okay, perfect. This is going to, as you can see, really increase the amount of money, and part of the reason for that is because we are no longer paying as much money on upkeep. Each of these guys that's now a master of soldiers is increasing the decreasing the unit upkeep costs, so that's fantastic. Quintus Symmachus, actually, you're already in office. Let's get you up to military count. Let's get you up to military count, why not? Actually, no, I don't want you spending your hard-earned political capital on that sort of stuff right now. Because I would love to get more people adopted into the family. And you can see that our governors are slowly chugging away on that slow and steady sort of thing. Okay, so, yeah, you're already in office. Praetex Taxis, you're already in office. You're already in office. All right, let's get Hilarius in office. And we'll get Spurius, I guess, in office here. I don't actually care about my military counts quite as much. They just aren't that important. We are down quite a bit in terms of power. I would love to get back up to balanced, but we're spending with our military counts as fast as is possible. I mean, every time we do this, I think our dominion goes up a little bit because we... Yeah, it's by percentage of how much influence you have, so... This means that our influence percentage will increase with the family, and it'll go down a little bit with theirs, so it's fine. It's fine. We're going to go ahead and pick up Hereditary Service. It's relatively cheap right now, and it'll drop that cost that we're paying even further, so that should be okay. Looks like we have got the Rebellion up in Hedramentum. We're going to go ahead and go into normal stance here. Let's check this. This place is looking okay. It'll last a little bit longer before another Rebellion. I don't know if we could actually run these guys down without them fleeing, so we're going to move up to Hedramentum, and we'll let them brew another turn, I think. How many rebellions do we have brewing? Just Magna Graecia, so do we have any spare generals, and will we after we recruit another army? We will. Do we have any spare generals left in other patricians here? Yes, another one joined this group, so... As long as we keep getting more generals added to that, things are okay. Alright, you should get back to Tingis for now. That'll drop the unhappiness there to nothing, basically. And we can get these guys sprinting their way up the coastline towards that fleet there. I have to hunt it down, which is going to be a problem, because I suspect we're going to have some problems there. Fortunately, we've only got this dramatic paganism problem over in Uberzus. What's that changing it to? Yeah, minus 9 per turn. Brutal. Alright, we can reach Colonia Agrippina with this army, so we might as well. They'll save us the agony of having to get another one there. Lugdunum is a walled city, and these guys are taking winter attrition, but that doesn't really excuse anything. Alright, so we probably could go ahead and attach a group to here. And that should be the only one we need to for this turn, I think. No, we also needed one here. So that will be two generals, so we do actually need to get rid of this stack here. Okay, I don't know if I've got enough movement is the problem, like I said. Well, what we could do is we can disband a couple of units. And if we get our army force down to close to their composition, we should be able to attack them, and the result should be that they don't run away from us there. Alright, these guys are in that stance in somewhere that's getting winter attrition. I can't really do a whole lot about that. So we're just going to have to sort of sit tight here. They'll have to do something eventually. We might be able to get peace with them, though. It looks like they're being bullied from some other sides here. Can I trade with Judea? No, I can't. It's a lot of sort of new factions poking their heads into existence as people rebel against their former masters or whatever. So good for them, getting their independence like that. But, you know, they should trade with me if they could. Which they can't, but, you know, they should. Ostrogoths? Where the hell are the Ostrogoths? Got the Visigoths right there. All right, they really hate me, but
I'm sure you have many pleasanter
success is low. Damn. All right, can I get peace with anything really? They would be pointless because I'm trying to kill them. That's a mission. It's only 2,000, but I would love to get a piece of them.
Speak.
Love to crush them. Piece by crushing them. Okay. So I think we can also try and get a little bit of cash just by asking now. It's been enough turns that I suspect we can.
The blessings of the Lord upon you. What then do your noble people desire of us?
Yeah, so this is moderate. That's low, so it's probably less than 1,300. It's probably more like... Probably ask for 900? Rejected. Let's go down a bit. If we waited longer, we could probably ask for, like, 900, but... Alright, if they won't give us 750, we'll just wait until they're... Because they really like us here. Alright, so we'll just wait. I think that has to recharge a little bit more. Other factions like the Bastarnians, like us a little bit. They are probably busy fighting the Huns, so they're probably just about out of the game. Abdanians over here, we can ignore them. Franks. I mean, they're starting to dislike me a little bit more and more and more, but... These guys, we should be okay with those guys. Garamantians, like, we should be really okay with these guys. Should be okay with these guys. If anyone ever kills their kings, we're going to be in trouble because they stop being defensive, potentially. These guys are at war with the Dacians and the Saxons, so they're kind of not a threat to us right now. Macedonians are at war. These guys are defensive. Yeah, I don't know if we're going to be able to catch up to those Marians with anything, but... Such is the way of life sometimes. Would you guys join in any of our wars?
What you say had better please my ears.
Low. Could I get them to migrate towards the Jutes? What about the Ostrogoths? Low, okay. Saxons? Alright, so that'll just lower the chances that we end up in a war with the Roxolanians. Alright. Blah, blah, blah. Alright, so what we have to do is we have to try and drop this army down to a size where these guys will be willing to fight us on the field. And then we have to crush their army so completely that they don't threaten us anymore. Let's go ahead and dismiss all of these units. And then we'll just have him and the garrison from Hadrumentum. That'll give us 5 units against their 4. So we should be able to completely beat them, but still have enough presence on the battlefield that we can win this fight. So I think that was probably our best call. Looks like they've also got a catapult, so that works out in our favor as well. Although the Kantarii, again, dangerous, dangerous unit. So we'll see you on the battlefield. All right, here we are. So let's go stamp out a tiny rebellion here. We are going to retreat with our general way to the back line here, and the reason being, of course, that I cannot risk my general in the early stages of this fight before my reinforcements have shown up, so... Huh, they're coming from the side. A little bit strange given the context, but...
Not a moment too soon.
Now, I didn't know what one of their units was, but it looks like it was... Yeah, Exploratores. So they're severely lacking in infantry right now. Exploratores, still kind of a crappy unit. We'll use our bows yet again to replenish, to deplete the ammunition, opposite of replenish, of the catapults.
Form loose formation.
Same old formula. Part of the reason it's so important to do that is because, really, if you don't, you do have that risk that they're going to start sniping at your general with their artillery. It's what I tend to do with my artillery when it's spare. So it's not as though it's an unfounded risk. Because of the low unit counts in this one, and because they've got Kantarii, my general is going to be at more risk than normal. I'm going to have to use Scout Equites to sort of crash into these after they've charged into whatever they decide to charge into. Because of that, we're probably going to end up losing a lot of troops in this fight, but again, it is a garrison, so it's a little bit safer for me to lose troops from it, so... Alright, how close are we to that line? I'll wait till my troops have all sort of caught up a little bit before I commit to this fight here, so... Let's go ahead and... Do that. Alright, General, catch up to your troops. Eventually, there we go. There we go. All right, let's start inching our way up there, by which I mean pretty big leap. We aren't going to have that many pylons throughout the Katsari-E if they start coming from my archers, but it's probably going to be okay. I don't think they are likely to rush them out to the archers here, even if we don't have them too closely supported by the infantry. And if I do see them making a run at my archers, I'll run them back while I run my spears forward. Alright, yeah, here we go. So much better in this game when you can take out these rebellions when they're small. And that's why it's nice to have loose generals that you can rotate in and out of the conflict zones. They're one of your best resources in this game. Alright, well, we're taking some hits here, but nothing too bad so far. Yeah, I think that these catapults here are going to probably kill about what we usually see, 30 to 40. Well, a little bit less than 30 this time. Okay. And they're out of ammunition now, so we can go ahead and tighten this formation back up. And what we're going to do is, yet again, we're going to have... I'm going to rotate our units to different areas here. For a couple of reasons, of course. But we need to get the Comitatensis into that cavalry there. We need to get our general and cohorts into their exploratores and other similar units. And we're going to have our archers firing at those Kantarii. So let's change our formation to this. Alright, there we go. A little bit wonky shaped, but that's fine. We want to go ahead and get our archers moving up here, so when we do get in range, we're going to just have them directly firing at the Kantarii. We can sort of ignore their infantry to a certain extent here. We're just going to have them, we're going to try sandbagging against them a little bit with our cohorts. We're going to have to upgrade those cohorts to Legio pretty soon, and like, it is a good idea to actually upgrade them to the second level of Legio. I forget what, or third level rather. Like, I think it's Armored Legio? Can't really remember 100% there. But, the garrisons become extremely powerful once you've got them to their second level, because that unit is just so much better than what I've got with cohorts. Cohorts are a crappy unit, is the thing.
Attack, you worthless dogs! Advance at speed! Quick march! At speed!
Okay, we're stopping with our cohorts here, because I do want them to start using their... I shouldn't have charged there, but I was a little bit worried that we were out of position anyway. Okay, let's get into... Oh, wow, actually, they got wrecked. Let's get into these exploratories. Now, exploratories kind of do have good, decent melee attack abilities and stuff like that, so they aren't completely useless. Alright, and this is where the scout equites being in that fight are useful. We'll keep shooting at them, but it's more important that I continue on with the general's under attack indeed. Alright, so those Kantarii, I would love it if they would shatter. They're down to quite a lot. There they go. Yeah, let's go ahead and switch to these. Get around the back here a little bit, but more so than anything, we're going to go ahead and get this charge here. We'll cycle out once we've got a good hit there. One of the weird things about this game is that the charge bonus doesn't instantly go away.
We outnumber the enemy.
So it's worth sticking your unit in after the charge for a little bit there. Alright, they've got those exploradores out. Firing at their general from the back there. And we got a good volley off of that. Got 6 kills with them. Probably dealt a lot of damage. I'm going after these exploratories right now because it's more important for me to wipe out this army completely than it is for me to win quickly. Did win quite quickly, though. Alright, so our strategy worked out pretty much perfectly there. We only lost, like, 50, 60 of these Comitatensis, and everyone else has actually been pretty good health. Alright, now we need to just completely wipe that Palatina Guard, because, you know, you never know when you've got one person left in the unit and that person happens to be the general. So, let's go ahead and fast forward this as we mow down the last remnants of this tiny rebel faction. We'll put them up on crosses along the road. I forget what road they actually did that to Spartacus and his rebels, but I bet it's this guy. Are you Spartacus? They all said they're Spartacus, but I don't know which one of them is actually Spartacus, so we just have to kill them all. Alright, so, yeah, you can see that the Exploradores actually got a decent number of kills. It's the fact that they're so squishy that makes them less intimidating. So, you know, it's an interesting unit, but ultimately they're not great for the Roman style of war when you've only got a Palatina to sort of absorb attacks. The fact that they're a scout unit means that you can... Alright, so I guess I'll see you guys on the campaign map. Alright, so here we are again, and let's grab that tiny bit of cash. I mean, if we keep doing it, it'll gradually start working its way into a helpful position. What's going on here? Oh, right, dramatic pagan opposition. Right, we're not going to worry about that. It's going to tie up people around Uberzus, but that's fine. Let's go ahead and go a bit of... Oh, what did he get here? The Vulgate. Interesting. Alright, let's go ahead and get Ducks and Sentinel. Start those up there, and that should be okay. I probably need to get this guy actually another level of Legatus, come to think of it, because he... he could use another one of those just to put that on par. And I wish there was a loyalty skill. Is there one? Yeah, because it doesn't make sense for them to get loyalty as they get stronger, so I guess that's the thing. Well, either way, we've managed to secure his loyalty, so it's relatively okay right now. Not the worst. So, what have we got for rebellions in this region? Leptis Magna and Carthago is fine. We have actually a fairly sizable garrison over here in Mauritania, so we can dismiss this general now. We'll have to send another one down to this region pretty soon, but for now we've got a moment where we've got this area clear of rebels, and now that we've got the governor's house here in Carthago, they're helped out quite a bit in terms of their public order. So what we have to do is think about what we're going to do in Leptis Magna, because we don't have this public order in order here at all. We need the growth here to go in here. When's the next growth required for population surplus is 63. Growth next turn is 43, but that, I think, is not how much we're gaining. I think that's... Maybe that is how much we're gaining. Might be 2 turns, but I think it's actually more like 3 or 4 turns or something like that. I think we're only getting plus 7 per turn. So, that's not necessarily that great. Let's see how we're doing elsewhere. Can we get rid of any of these other armies? Oh, right, we had rebels to deal with elsewhere. We moved these guys up to Colonia Agrippina, but they're there to block any sort of attack from potentially the Jutes that are still coming towards me, but not necessarily right now. We had you guys. Alright, I had to deal with these guys, but unfortunately it's winter. That sucks, but... Alright, what can we recruit here? And do we need to recruit anything? Commander? I would say almost definitely we do. Okay, we could get another one of these mercenary Celtic cavalry raiders. That could be a good choice. Relatively cheap, highly effective, and pretty good against most AI army compositions. And let's go ahead and charge into this. We've got the reinforcement range. We've got, I think that everyone is alive in Seguntium here. Oh wow, this place needs a bathhouse upgrade badly. Let's get that regardless of anything else. Although, actually, we might be having a bad winter here. Yeah, this is actually having a bad winter. We don't actually need this. It's just that we're having a ton of squalor for the bad winter effect. We should actually check to see how many places are having those. Lamatia is having a bad winter. Britannia Inferior is having a bad winter. Britannia is having a good winter. I want to see what the good winter effect is. Alright. You guys... Wait, why are we still at minus 20 happiness here? Or plus 20. Plus 1? Oh, I thought that said minus 20. Growth bonus, the Pillars of Hercules, good winter. Sanitation plus 2 and plus 10% from industrial buildings. That's what I thought it was. Although I think that the plus 2 from... Oh right, crap, we needed another army here. Shit. I think the bonus from industrial is actually just any province. Yeah, so this province is making more money this turn because they've got lots of industrial, which is good. Tarko having a good winter. Aquitania having a good winter. Okay, so I guess it's kind of even, actually. I was wondering if we were going to get screwed by the effects there. Alright, so is this enough? I really hope this is enough. Let's get in there. Ooh. That's an ugly-looking rate of victory, but you know what? The four units here are probably things like Scout Equites and Exploratores. If they're mostly Scout Equites, we should have this in the bag. The one problem is we took a lot more attrition than I thought we were going to, but we've got pretty even numbers on the battlefield, so the difference must be that this is all cavalry. So we should be able to win that if it's all Scout Equites. So we'll see you on the battlefield for this quick rebel fight. Alright, so here we are on the battlefield. I don't actually know if smoke is beneficial to me in this, or fog is beneficial to me in this particular match. Oh man, this forest is going to be brutal. Let's try going without fog just so that I can actually figure out what's going on in the battlefield. Oh crap. Okay, there we go. Because there's so much forest here, it would be really hard to actually see what's going on otherwise, so... we can go ahead and deploy, like, approximately here. I don't think there's anything wrong with the... Oh crap. I don't think there's anything wrong with this starting position. They do have very, very little in terms of... They have no range units. Those are all Exploratores. Interesting. Okay, so if I can get the Contarii with the Mercenary Celtic Cavalry Raiders, and if I can cause them to use up their catapult shots on my archers, like we usually do, this will be a really easy fight, actually, because I can kite these guys without... Oops, that's the wrong button. Stall skirmish mode. Get back on your horses. There we go. So we actually outnumber them in terms of cavalry quite badly, which is rare for me. Oh, shit. What? How? How?
The enemy has been sighted.
Alright, let's get you guys over here. Let's get these guys visible. Why? How is this possible? Oh right, I didn't actually have my army coming up from the goddamn city this time. Okay, you guys get into the woods. Oh man, I'm glad. I've never been so glad for obscured vision. Okay, let's get you guys sort of... Actually, we could probably get across and join up our... link up our armies sort of over here. Okay, what is the range of that catapult? Probably not over here. Okay, let's just get you guys over there. Let's get these guys through the woods, over the river and through the woods. Not going to our grandmother's house, because that would be a horribly rude thing to invite all of these scraggly, warlike sorts to my grandmother's house. But over the river and through the woods, regardless. I forget where that song actually originates from. Like, I know I saw it in Charlie Brown, but I get the feeling that it doesn't come from Charlie Brown. Alright. How are you guys all doing? You know, I'm surprised actually that the Celtic Axeman take winter attrition. I would have thought they wouldn't have. Yeah, well, either way. I'm gonna scout out in this open terrain here with the archers, see if they'll start firing the catapult at them. Not in range here, are we? Good. Okay, I think we should be... Well, we'll actually do an approach like this. We can get you guys out this way. Okay, this is such a weird fight. Yeah, they're shifting their lines to accommodate the fact that they've seen new units here. Oh crap, that's within range of the catapult. Let's move over this way a little bit. Alright. I don't want to be on the move with my side facing it, because then they're firing enfilade, which causes a lot more casualties to happen, especially something that rolls down your lines like that. So let's go ahead and pop these guys into range here. And we should be able to run them out of ammunition pretty quickly here. Why does theirs have rapid reload? Oh, that's not a Celtic Onager. That, right, okay, that's why. Alright, so our archer's going to get trashed just a little bit, but that's fine. Got ourselves our battle line here. And it should be a good enough battle line to resist the Exploratore so long as I can use my cavalry well, which is going to be the key to this fight. Want to kill those scout equites and the equites, we want to kill more than anything their Contarii. I thought they had Contarii, maybe I was wrong. But I could have sworn they had another cavalry unit. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, yeah, they must have another cavalry unit on their other flank by their general, maybe? I mean, we could also assassinate their general. Alright, is their catapult out of ammunition? Yes, it is, indeed. I can't actually see their Contarii, but I'm pretty sure that they had it. Might have actually been an Equites Dalmatia. I know they had a scary cavalry unit. Alright, you guys switch to Flaming Shot. Gonna be responsible for taking out their cavalry. These mercenary cavalry raiders seem to usually beat things like scout equites. Oh yeah, there they are. Alright, so let's get around to the side here. Turn you guys on to fire at will. You guys aren't on skirmish behavior, correct? Okay. Alright, we're starting to fire a little bit at them. We've got that Parthian shot. We're gonna move forcibly back a little bit closer to these guys. And then move away again. And you can see that we're starting to take some shots at these Contarii. Why are you guys not running? Keep running. Oh god. Right. Right, so they've somehow caught up to my band there. Which is really bad. Let's just charge them in the back there, and that'll actually do a lot of damage to them. I think we'll actually still win that fight against the Contarii either. So we're not actually too worried yet.
The men have thrown down their weapons and are fleeing!
Now the problem is that they got charged, so they actually do ridiculously poorly when that happens. The Contarii being attacked from the back there by those guys should actually be enough to give these guys enough time to rally. The axe unit should be able to crush the Exploratore. As you can see, those Contarii actually are shaken already.
Beware! Our hidden units have been revealed!
Alright.
We're being ambushed!
And these scout equites I'm not too concerned about. Actually, let's get these guys in wall formations. Let's turn you guys off fire at will. Move you guys sort of back here. General, let's get him into this formation here. Use him to potentially absorb the cavalry charge of the enemy. Or they'll go into the side of this unit, giving me a chance to countercharge.
Kill, kill, kill.
Alright, let's get our axes good charges here. And let's go ahead and...
Unit has used all its ammunition.
Shit, I think I was accidentally using up ammunition with this unit. Oh yeah, oh well. The fact that I'm lagging so hard here is definitely not helping anything. Alright. Well, I think that you guys get the idea of how to fight rebels at this point in time anyway, so let's not worry about it, and let's go ahead and end the episode here. I hope you found this one enjoyable. Been fighting tons and tons of rebel stacks all turn, but anyway, yeah, I hope you found this episode enjoyable, and of course, as always, I hope to see you all next time.